My dear shareholders, I am now delighted to make an announcement about the biggest foreign investment in the history of Reliance.
So it's an interesting day for India's energy security given the announcement which was done by Mukesh Ambani. In fact, Mr. Ambani announced today at the AGM, he talked about how Saudi Aramco, which is the largest oil producer in the world, will be acquiring a 20% stake in Reliance Industries refining and petrochemical business. Now, why is this news important, apart from the sheer scale of it? Because this 20% he's talking about in the OTC business, which is the oil to chemical business, which will have an enterprise value of around $35 billion. Apart from the valuation part of it, the news holds a lot of importance for India's energy security, given that around 83% of India's oil needs are imported today. Aramco is not only the world's largest oil producer, Aramco also has the heft to control the dynamics of what happens in an OPEC as well. So what this deal essentially does is, apart from equity which Aramco takes in Reliance OTC business, it will also be supplying crude oil to the refineries at Jamnagar. So what it essentially does is there is a supply security, there's also energy security, specifically at a time when there is already a lot of uncertainties happening in the Gulf. Given the tensions in the Straits of Hormuz, this is absolutely a shot in the arm for not only Reliance, but also India's energy security. What it means for India, it also means a substantive move for Aramco. Aramco, unlike other oil producers in the world, is a state-owned entity. Now, if you look at the way that the Indian energy space is organized today, Aramco is also coming to India for other reasons as well. This is a time when producers across the world have been looking at India because it gives them an access to the consumers as well. So if you look at the size of the consumer base here, that's the reason why Rosneft made a play for SR, which then became Nayara Energy. And that's precisely the reason why Aramco wants to be present in this country. Apart from what Aramco is doing or planning to do with Reliance, it also has a plan to set up the largest refinery in this part of the world, which will be a $44 billion oil refinery and petrochemical complex, which has got the state-owned players as partners for Aramco there. So these are all pieces which are now coming together for Aramco. If you look at the way that some of these West Asian companies have been looking at India, ADNOC, which is a state-owned company of United Arab Emirates, also picked up a stake in the refinery which Aramco is trying to set up with the Indian state-owned oil refiners. So when you look at the entire play today, this is absolutely the kind of a game-changer moment, not only for the players involved, which is the Reliance Industries Limited or a Saudi Aramco, but also for the India's energy security, which has been increasingly looking outwards for importing crude oil, given that India doesn't produce enough of crude oil of its own. Also, it comes at a time when India has become the refining capital of the world. A lot of crude which comes to India is not only meant for consumption here after it gets converted into product, be it an ATF, MS, which is a motor spirit or a petrol, or a HDS, which is diesel. It also gets exported out to other economies as well. India has become a major exporter of product as well, and this will be helping India in earning the forex revenues as well. So in all, a very important day for India's energy space. We also see it at a time when Aramco will be joining the league, which we have seen, say, a BP is already here for the downstream marketing business. We have already seen a Rosneft coming with acquiring SR, which resulted in Nayara Energy. We also have indication of other oil majors as well lining up to get into this market, which is one of the last remaining final frontiers. It also comes at a time when overall, globally, there is a shift towards from ICE, which is the internal combustion engines, to the EV technology.